We have one of our best personalities, entertainers in town. Ron Knight is back with us, and it's always a pleasure, man. And thank you for inviting me out. The last one was a smash up there at the
Sterling Club.
Sterling Club, yeah. I always get Sterling and Foundation Room.
I know, because they're very similar.
But and they make me, I just remember this hold my nose up when I go in these places.
Yeah.
Glenn, you're going to have to stick your nose up a little more.
Just to get too much money in the building.
Yes, I have friends from Harvard. My friend always say, let me tell you about my friends in Harvard.
Too much money in the building, huh?
There you go. Well, man, good seeing you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you too, man.
And time I see you, you remind me, you got to take care of yourself. Always looking like you just finished working out.
No, yeah, trying, man. You know, when you're a singer, man, you know.
And I'm going to say this to the audience. He's not a singer. He's a singer. He sings. All right, he don't sing, he sang. That means a lot of people can sing the song, but he performs the song. That's a singer. And Ron, you sang well, man. And your little secret weapon, your wife, I was pleased to see her make it do what it do at the Sterling Club. And so a lot of great things are happening.
Talking about Kimberly, man. She does a lot.
She does a lot. She does a lot. So always working on something. You got something happening this Friday.
Mm-hmm.
And you are, we're talking about Black history, and you are an African-American.
Sure.
Are you? I don't know. Are you? Are you from America?
Yeah, I'm originally from.
Because you know, some people call and see your birth certificate.
Oh yeah.
No, okay, so you are from America.
Yeah, I'm from America.
You know, I'm saying that because you won Star Search in Australia, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Like what, 10 times or something? 8, 10?
Oh man, at least nine times. 9 or 10 times.
And that's
they wouldn't let me go off the show.
Really? Mm.
Wow. I came back as a host.
You ran a tab up there. They said, "No, you're gonna pay for it."
Yeah.
Right. I was always like, man, talking to you was like meeting a guy or somebody, you're flying from coast to coast, when it was safe, of course, and you guys just start chopping it up.
Yeah.
And so
we were out of town most of the time.
So tell us about this one right here you got going.
This song here is a B.B. King song, which I rearranged and did in a jazz form. And, look, what can I say about B.B. King? This song has always been, since B.B. King recorded it, in the top 20.
Okay.
All the way up until now.
All right, let's hear it. Thriller's gone, huh?
Thriller's gone.
Thriller's gone.
Thriller's gone, man.
Thriller's gone away. To him. He ain't no joke.
You done me wrong, baby.
Look at you, Ron.
You gonna be sorry someday.
He not talking about you, Kimberly. You know that, right? Thrill ain't gonna never be gone.
Thrill's gone. Thrill is gone away from me.
Built you a big old house, baby. Was it just an act?
back. Although I still live on. So lonely I'll be. I'm free, baby.
Come back again. Ow! Ron Knight, see? Let's talk over this. 91.5 Jazz and More, Brother Ron Knight. I love this song, man.
Right.
Let me tell you what I like about this song. This one is, you said you got her all this stuff, and now she want to give it back to you.
Yeah.
That's a good woman right there. Yeah. You know? Most people are like, not only do I want what you gave me, I want what you got too. I pulled up today, a Bentley. I was right in front of me.
Uh-huh.
License plate said, was his.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, was his. She got him.
Yeah.
So you wasn't writing that song about her?
No.
So, Ron, man, you went in the lab. You know, I was a little apprehensive because certain artists you don't fool with.
Yeah, right, I got you.
B.B. Kings and James Brown.
That's right.
But you nailed it. Mm. You nailed it. Yeah. Gone.
You know, that was a suggestion for one of the musicians I had in Australia. He used to love the song. He said, man, I'm telling you, man. He said, you could do some justice to this song. He said, but make it a jazz tune.
Yeah, that's nice, right?
And I did it. I recorded it with him. Recorded it in Australia.
Okay.
And we nailed it. Kimberly and them are doing the background
vocals. It sounds like you had one on the Barbie there.
Yeah,
from down under, my friend.
From the Barbie.
Okay, well, listen, folks. This is 91.5 Jazz and Boy. Ron, stick around for a minute. I love company. Company is good every once in a while. Here's the genius, and I mean this. Stevie, you need to wonder. Boogie on, Raggae Woman, on 91.5 Jazz and More. Ron Knight's in the house, performing this Friday at the Sterling Club, 6 o'clock tonight.
That's right, right across from the West Gate.
6 to 9, works for me.
At Turnberry.
About every artist. I mean, I would be remiss to get out of this song without you telling me something you know about Stevie or worked with him or what. What's your story?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Let me tell you, Stevie and I are still friends till this day, man.
Uh-huh.
I don't see him very much.
He don't see you very much, Stevie.
No, that's right.
But go on.
But Stevie and I met in 1972, really.
Uh-huh.
I think we were both about 18 years old.
Right.
And he was traveling with Louise and a guy named John and Louise. And I happened to be at a party.
You were finishing up about
Stevie. Yeah. Stevie Wonder and I met when we were 18 years old.
Uh-huh.
And I actually got called to Motown at the time.
Right.
Louise, who was representing him at the time, asked me, did I want to come? But I got drafted, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and they told me, and I was looking in my mailbox, you know how the Social Security checks
right.
are?
You did your duty, right?
Yeah, you know.
Yeah, they tried to draft me. I told them to draft Root Beer.
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
I ended up doing USO instead.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, good. you and Stevie, I'm just going to put it out there.
Sure.
Can you reach him? You got his number?
Yes, I do have his number.
Okay, all right. Yeah. I'll be hitting you up for that one.
folks,
we got the amazing Ron Knight is in the building. He's a favorite of 91.5 Jazz and More. But right now, we're going to get back to the music as we do this. Turn it up!
Galaxy Glenn is getting you back to the music than any other station in Southern Nevada. Your station, 91.5 KUNV.
You know, so that in turn got me to meet these dudes. What's the name was on here? And I missed him. Ralph.
At 1.5 Jazz and More, Side by Side, The Afternoon Drive. It's your man, Galaxy Glenn. Shout out to my church fam, Covenant Christian Fellowship, Pastor Ron, Stanfield, and the crew, folks. And we are broadcasting from Greenspun Hall on the campus of UNLV. This is listener-supported 91.5 Jazz and More, KUNV, FM, and HD1, Las Vegas. And it's my pleasure to have Ron Knight in the studio.
Oh, glad to be here, man, always.
You know, you just can't have a guy like you and not. I always get a nugget from you, man, whether it's the people you worked with. And I was just telling your wife, you are so true to your craft.
Until I die, man. You know, this is what I chose.
I mean, no, when I say that, listen, Las Vegas, I mean true to the craft. Some people get in this game for the money. Some people get in this game for the fame. Some people get in this game, they want to be the big eye. They want to feel like, you know, they make an impact. And a lot of them need to just stay home. Mm. But you have been so true to your craft, man, and it's never a stop with you. And
I'm always producing.
Now I'm hearing whispers that never knew love before.
Yeah.
Miss Dionne Warwick
is going to be at the Sterling Club. Man.
I'm hearing whispers, and that's,
I'm giving her you know, some play because I respect her so much, man. You know,
you hear that, folks? You know, that's just like me saying, you know, yeah, I'm gonna let Steve Harvey come in here and then open the mic one time. but you're so true to your craft, man, and I thank you for dropping by. And
well, I can tell you, you know, there's a lot of programs that I don't do. I told you before.
Right.
But your program is, I'm telling you, it's off the chain. I listen to you all the time.
I appreciate it.
You know, whenever I'm in, when I come out of my studio, man, I go right there, turn it on, because you're playing some songs that a lot of people haven't heard for a long time.
Kudos to the staff and management.
Yeah.
Mainly me. But it's such a comfortable place. Mm. I don't dread pulling up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
I don't dread it, and I love it. And I serve an audience that appreciates 91.5 Jazz and More for over 40 years. Mm. And we're getting ready to have another fundraiser to keep this thing turning. And you are a member too, so we're gonna get into your other cut here. Tell us about this one.
This is a cut that I had. I thought about it a few years back, as a matter of fact. About being in a nightclub,
okay.
me and a friend, and this is what came out from me and a friend being in a club, man, checking out the chicks in the club.
Okay, well,
up in the,
and here it is, ladies and gentlemen.
Friday night.
I just got to get me one. Hey, what about you, man? Did you bring any money with you? We got to spend some tonight. It's Friday night. Time for me to play. I'm going to the nightclub. I'm gonna get my way. Girls all around. I'm acting like a fool. If one approaches me, I'll be talking smooth. I'm wearing clothes. The best that money can buy.
Somebody shaking it too hard over there. Somebody, last call there. 91.5 Jazz and More, Side by Side, the Afternoon Drive. Another big shout out to the lovely and beautiful and such an amazing Miss Josephina. Thank you for being you and your lovely daughter, who is your biggest fan supporter. And I see how you shaped and molded her. We're thankful for you And we're getting ready, folks. We're calling all our loyal listeners and renewed members because we're getting ready to have that drive again, okay. Ron. And to keep this thing flowing and going. I want another good story, though, because I love good stories. I'm going to throw artists out there, and then you can tell me your link, too. Let's see. I think we talked about Marvin Gaye before.
Yeah, we talked about Marvin Gaye.
Let's talk about somebody like Smokey Robinson where I could do some fact checks because he's still here.
Yeah.
And I want to tell me about Smokey.
Well, Smokey and I met quite some time ago. As a matter of fact, I met Smokey before I actually met him the second time. Oh, no.
Wait a minute. Did you guys hear that, guys? He said he met him before he met him the second time. I can't write this stuff. This guy's incredible.
You know what I mean? So, but I was working Kiss nightclub. You remember on Sahara and Decatur, the Kiss nightclub? And a lady was in the back, and I was performing with Mike Clark and Clifton Davies on drums.
Yeah, Clifton Davies on drums. Okay.
Yeah,
and so this is like in 2000.
Yeah, and so a lady was sitting in the back that lived way up in that really rich section of Red Rock.
Yeah, I'm familiar with.
And so she said to me, she said, "Hey, look, I've been listening to you. Would you like to come and play a party for me?" And I said, "Yeah." She said, "Do you come?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "Well, give me a price," and she said, "But I'd like to have you up there." So Kimberly and I go up there, and at that time I was doing the song "Ooh Baby Baby."
You know, and Smokey was there.
Smokey was at the party, and I had Kimberly sing the song because she sings in that key.
Okay.
And from there, Smokey and I became friends from that party.
Wow.
That was at Red Rock.
That's a great story. That is a great. That's why. Yeah. We definitely want to. Well, reason why I asked you about Smokey because I have a Smokey story too.
Okay.
And he's a good golfer, and we golfed together. And I asked him if he had some free time, could he in fact pop in?
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "Galaxy, anytime." So we definitely want to let him know. I know he's listening. Smokey, you're welcome to drop on.
And I haven't seen him for a while, so he should call me in the same day.
Yeah,
give some stories.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you a little bit about Prince, because we can't confirm or deny it, so you can make it real good if you want to.
Right on.
Have you met with Prince? You met Prince
No,
before?
I didn't meet with Prince, but Prince actually hired two of my goddaughters to dance with him. And they were dancing with him up until he died.
Wow.
Maya and Nandy.
Okay.
Maya and Nandy, two Australian girls that have known me and their father. He was the guitar player for me.
DB, I see, boy. Hey, California Love. Super Bowl's in California.
Yeah.
Rams, Cincinnati. Just be honest. I mean, are you buzzing about it? It don't seem the same, huh?
No, it don't seem the same. But I kind of.
You don't have Brady. You don't have it's. I think if they had Kansas City in there, and Cincinnati, don't get me wrong, I don't have a dog in the fight. You know, I'm a Cowboy fan and a Raider fan, for PR reasons. But and I'm from Cali, but I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. And then Brady's still in the highlights.
I'm going to predict.
Who do you think?
I honestly believe that the Bengals are going to win the Super Bowl.
You know what? That golden guy, I think he's going to be the predecessor of Brady. The quarterback for Cincinnati, he is the truth.
And I knew Garoppolo would blow that game. I knew he would because I told her. I said, Garoppolo, no way, okay.
All right, let's see. Let's see if there's a fumble in the traffic right now. Ain't nobody's business but mine and my baby. I'm gonna play another Michael Jackson. It is definitely a terrific Tuesday. Let it be no mystery, celebrating Black history as African Americans have made such a tremendous contribution to the world as we know it. And some of the great music you heard is pioneers of it, and we'll be celebrating it all year long for me. But certainly in February is set aside. Well, you're a pillar, Ron, and you have done some great things, and always good having you, man.
Still
you always,
trying, man.
You know, I was asked one time, Galaxy, you the complete entertainer. Who does it for you? It's people like you.
That's all right, man.
It's people like you that do it for me.
That's all right,
you know
man.
What I mean? And
that's
I just pray to Jay, when I get to your age, I'm still kicking his eyes I am, and still passionate about whatever I'm deemed to do, my purpose in his plan.
Till the end, till we the go. End.
So tell us on the boat, what's happening?
Sterling Club this Friday night. Uh-huh. It's also combined with the fashion show from Anne Fontaine. Some beautiful clothes for the women.
High-end
stuff. Yes, nice high-end stuff. And but not so much high-end as far as
nice
price.
Nice looking,
stuff,
I'm talking
but
about.
But it's very nice very looking classic. and quality.
Yeah.
Anne's always been a complete sponsor for us in the Music and Fashion Expo, too, as well.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, will be coming up sometimes in July and in August. I'll be back on, hopefully, back on your show to let you know all about that.
The door's
might
open.
Even get you to host that sucker.
The door's open. The door's wide open now.
You know what I
mean? You know, I say, you retain me, I'm in.
There you go.
Hey, folks, you know? It's been real. It's been fun. In fact, it's been real fun. And I want to say the clock on the wall says that's just about all. Stick a fork in me, I'm done. Hey, don't forget, we start bright and early, 6 a.m. in the morning. Get you going. Kevin Crawl, that's it, that's all. Along with the Queen of Flow, Carlea. And, of course, from 8 to noon, you better know it. John Nashin, mashing for rations. He is the man around here. He is the man. And, of course, coming up at 12 is the beloved Kim Lindsay from 12 to 3, and she passes it to me, and I do the best I can. And that's usually pretty darn good, I must say. And baby girl, she's in the house. Look at Tina Marie. Uh-oh, you're dressed in red, black, and green.
Hey, I'm going to hook you up with Chili Dog.
Crisscross colors. I don't know what she got on. But she must have turned the light on.
I'm hook you up with Chili Dog again, man.
Okay, do that. Y'all got please know. Hey, folks, remember, life is not a cakewalk. It's a faith walk. Never look down on nobody unless you're picking them up. All right? We want to love, not hate. Encourage, not discourage. Build, not destroy. We want to motivate, not manipulate. We definitely want to remember, no matter what you're going through, keep going. Don't get stuck. Don't get stuck. Keep going. Love on yourself and love somebody, huh? Hey, folks, we don't take it for granted. You have a choice, and we're glad you choose 91.5 Jazz and More. We're glad you chose 91.5 for the English majors out there. And we want to thank you, and keep it right here. Little Sis up next. God bless. I'm Galaxy Glenn. Stick a fork in me. I'm done.
Peace.